honor to work here at the Pendleton Art Center and to jury this exhibition. I believe we had almost 180 entries, which is really a large amount of work to look over. So I had a really tough task today in deciding what would be a very limited number of awards. But I really want to congratulate all of you and celebrate all of your work. I think all the work in here is really phenomenal, and it was tough for me to make choices. So thank you all for submitting and making my job so hard. So what I'll do is I'll go through best of show, first, second, and third for the adults, and then the honorable mentions for adults, and then we'll go to the teens. So our best of show is Kevin Boylan, and it's in this corner here. This is a blown glass piece called Jade Optic Spine Pickle. And I was really pretty delighted when I saw this piece. I felt that it really instantly drew my eye in. I was really attracted to it, in part largely because of its outstanding craftsmanship and its sort of form and functionality as well. And I just think, you know, it's a really nice space for it in this window where it sort of glows from behind, and we really see the luminosity of that glass. And also the reference, you know, it's called Jade Optic Spine Pickle, so sort of this reference to Chinese jewelry perhaps, right? Think about jade. And it really has a lovely sort of patterning that kind of draws the eye up into this spiral towards the top. So I thought this was really just a lovely piece, and I was really excited to see it here in the gallery. So I don't know if the artist is here tonight, but congratulations to him. Yes. All right, our first place, we're going to move back that way for the adults. Can you sort of roaming talk? Best of Friends, and it's an oil painting. And when I came into the gallery, I just kept coming back to this piece over and over again, and I would kind of like chuckle a little bit, and then sometimes think it was really creepy and kind of weird, like I can't tell if the cat is smothering the lady, or if like they're really best friends, like it felt like it could be ironic. So just in terms of the content of this piece, it was something that kind of kept me coming back and wanting to know more about this narrative. It's sort of a strange image here that I thought was really crafted beautifully in terms of the painting style and technique and the color palette used, right? We've got these cool colors and the lime green eyes and that hot red and the flesh tones. So it really had a nice variety of formal elements going on, as well as sort of the story behind it. So Best of Friends is our first for the adults.
Yeah, I got it.
Then our second place for the adults is Nikki Chimioti, which is actually back that way. I'm going to be moving around a lot.
And if you're an artist that's won an award and she's talking about your work, let us know you're here.
No, I'm Geraldine.
Oh, congratulations.
Nikki's not here.
So Nikki's piece is called This Is Lorraine. A sort of photorealistic style of a portrait full frontal. And I thought it was really a sort of raw and sort of honest portrait just of this individual, right? Just with all the sort of lines and wrinkles, not trying to beautify or glamorize or romanticize, but really just a nice image, especially when, again, color palette with the cools and the warms, a lot of movement and motion with all those lines and brush strokes. So I thought that was a really, really strong painting there. Mm-hmm. And then our third place for our adults is Catherine Treffinger. And her piece, is Catherine here?
No, Catherine?
Located up above here.
Excuse
me? Here we have an abstract oil painting. It's titled Galapagos. And again, this is another painting that I kept returning to in the gallery that I thought was really intriguing in terms of the composition. It's an abstract piece that kind of moves in and out of perhaps looking like something we can recognize, like it looks like netting, it also might look like clouds, or something like a building scape. And then just again, in terms of color palette, it was very striking with these hot colors and these cool colors kind of moving in and out of each other there. So I thought that was also a very strong piece. And for adults, we have a lot of honorable mentions. Again, it was really hard to select all these awards, but we have David Lochte, who also has an exhibition downstairs called Section Post, which I thought was a really lovely portrait of our region here, right, of the beautiful sort of landscape with the mountains and the wheat fields, and then a sort of split between night and day in the composition I thought was really nice. We also have an honorable mention here for this ceramic vessel by Bonnie Day and Tom Henderson, and it's called Soot on Vase. And it was one that was a bit more playful, and I thought was a little clever. You know, vases we often think of as vessels. We often think of them as referring to a body, as being something that holds, like a container, often with human-like sort of interpretations. And so the fact that it had this sort of cut-and-paste little figure right onto the vessel, I thought was a really nice little play there. Also for our honorable mentions for adults, we have Ann Hooper, located right here, the Sleeping Owl. And this, I was really interested in both of Anne's pieces. She has two here. In terms of the way she's using texture, Anne's here with us tonight. And also just sort of the sweetness of this form, this sort of like timid, delightful little owl here. And also the use of the materials with the steel base, just these materials kind of working nicely together. So that was really lovely. And then we also have Tricia Harding, which is located right back here. And our honorable mentions for adults. This is called Winter Blues, and the format to me reminded me a lot of a Japanese scroll, that sort of long, tall format, and I was interested in the mixing of materials, so especially this wood that's sort of placed on top of the collage, sort of fragments and segments of imagery, and then that sort of little pop where we zoom in and get those mountains, that sort of mountainscape in the back. So I was really interested in how this almost felt like comic, the sort of frames or fragments within a comic book, how the composition gets kind of pieced together. So that was also one in our honorable mentions.
Tricia, will you raise your hand?
And Tricia's here.
Yay.
Congratulations. And then lastly, lastly but not least, in our honorable mentions for adults, we have Julie Miller. Is she here with us?
No.
Nope? Okay. And Julie's piece is on the back wall here. I'm gonna move that way. Julie's piece is an encaustic painting, and I was especially attracted to the way she's using the encaustic material, media, working with not only this really vibrant color palette, you get these sort of segments or frames again, but just the way that I believe it seems like she must have placed the leaf, painted over it, and then taken a leaf out. So we kind of have this little excavated area where there's this impression or sort of ghost of where the leaves were. And if you get a closer look at it later in the show, it is quite lovely in terms of the textures and sort of quality that's going on there on a closer look. So congratulations to all of our adults in the adult category, and congratulations to all of you in the adult category. Next, we have our teen category, which is up here in the front, all together in a sort of L shape here, which I know will be hard for everyone to see. I'll try to talk loudly. Great to see so many teens enter. There's a lot of really nice entries here. Congrats to all of you. I hope you keep making art. It's a great pursuit to be creative.
Nice. Thank you.
So for our teens, our first place is Emma Bustamante Citrus. Is Emma here? Not here tonight? With her composition, it was sort of this like exercise in restraint, right? It's kind of this more quiet composition, a lot of negative space, leaving the white of the page. And then these sort of abstracted citrus fruits, like kind of painting them in a way that was not so realistic, but making them almost like a study in color. These nice gradations. I thought that was a really nice controlled use of the watercolors. That was really lovely. And our second place, Maddie Thompson. I don't know, what's the title? Maddie, congratulations. I thought this was really clever. Like, it was funny, and it was something that felt a little different in terms of media, of what we see here for the students. But a really nice use of materials, the textural quality here, if you can get up close with a sort of flower, or it could be skin, right? It has this sort of flipping between being beautiful, but also grotesque. Yeah, you know? It's got eyeball in the center, obviously a little on the gross side, but something that I also enjoyed that the viewer is looking at art, but then the art is actually looking back at you. So it has this nice kind of play. So congrats. Very cool, Maddie. And then our third for our students is Alicia Martinez. Alicia? And I was really excited about Alicia's way of using the collage format, right? Using found images and appropriated images. And working in particular, some of the mirror in the background kind of reflects the viewer back into the piece, but also the sort of splitting of the landscape and the sort of figure that's kind of falling back into the landscape. So it kind of set up this nice tension between the landscape and the figure. And then we finally have two honorable mentions for our teams. One is Juliet Chapman. She has, she's kind of hiding back here, but a really lovely mobile. Is Juliet here?
Yes.
Yes, congratulations. You can kind of hear it. It's some platen dinnerware that's kind of suspended here. But a really nice use of materials and play with found objects. And then finally, for our honorable mention for students, it's Kyron Darrow. Is Kyron here? Really great pen and ink drawing back here. Lovely composition, wonderful use of line and motion. And so that was also one of our final ones for the teams. So it was a real pleasure for me to look today. I think I looked for hours as I sat in the gallery and viewed the work. But it was really delightful, and I want to congratulate you all and say thank you so much for being a part of your community and making art in your